What's up, world? It's your boy Eric, and I'm back. It's been some years since I've done radio, but in the words of Little Kim, I've been gone for a minute, now I'm back with the jump off. This is The World According to Eric, where we will discuss all things entertainment, black entertainment. I got y'all in the mood. Gotta love Maxwell. Now, as y'all know, the Grammys are airing February 12th, and of course, I was all over those nominations. And I was here for some of them, I can't lie, but there were a few that I was just not get behind. So today, I have syndicated radio show host, Angelique Perrin. Angelique is the host of Cafe Mocha and will be sharing some of her thoughts with me on the Grammys, as well as Stephanie, who is a graduate student here in the Specialized Journalism Program. So how are you guys doing today?
We're good.
Good.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Have you guys looked at all at the nominations for the Grammys this year?
I have not.
Why? It's Beyonce, it's Taylor Swift, it's Rihanna, it's Bruno Mars. What is there to talk about?
It's
nothing
all
new.
Of that. It's all of that. But you know what? There has to be some type of reason why they are getting all of the nominations. This year, Beyonce has 9, which is the most, and Adele is following behind her with 5, I believe.
I forgot about Adele, yes.
Did you?
I mean, how could you?
Right, hello, is my question. How could you forget about Adele? So I just wanted to read off some nominations, and I want to get your thoughts on them. So the first one is Record of the Year. Hello by Adele. Formation by Beyonce. 7 Years by Lucas Graham. Work by Rihanna featuring Drake. And Stressed Out by 21 Pilots.
Who would I vote for?
Who would you vote for?
I just love Rihanna.
Do you? Yeah, I do.
I know I would get a lot of criticism because I prefer Rihanna to Beyonce, honestly.
What?
Yes, I know. And that's the reaction. I know, but I love her. I think her songs are so different from what Beyonce thinks about. And just overall, she comes off as she doesn't have a protected persona, which feels like she's more authentic. And I think that's why I like her so much, and her music resonates with me a lot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Angelique, how you feeling?
I'm feeling like Hello was in every format except for country and rock.
Every
station played Hello. I was told by my boss, do not play that song.
don't
play it one more time.
Don't.
So I Hello. Think
yeah. It's so sad. It's so sad. It puts
you
in
the
mood.
That's the way it starts out.
I don't know. It's just, I feel like I can hear Hello at a bar mitzvah, at a funeral, at a baptism. I'm just like, y'all got to stop playing this song. Goodbye is where I'm going with
next
it.
Next song.
Yes.
So the next nomination I want to run past you guys is Best Pop Solo Performance, which is once again Hello by Adele, Hold Up by Beyonce, Love Yourself by Justin Bieber, Piece by Piece, American Idol version by Kelly Clarkson, and Dangerous Woman by Ariana Grande. I personally love Ariana Grande. I think she's absolutely adorable.
She's adorable.
She's adorable. And she can sing. I want to give this
to
her.
She can sing, yes.
Yes, I want to give this to her because I feel like Beyonce and Adele are monopolizing the whole Grammy.
Well, they're huge.
They are huge.
How could they not? You
know? That's true.
Let's be honest. Ariana's not at that place yet.
She's not.
She's not there.
Like, if Beyonce's queen, you know, she's coming under as, like, princess and working herself up.
Yeah, she does need some dance lessons. I feel like that's the only thing stopping her. Because she can sing, she just cannot dance.
Oh, she does. It was excellent in interpretations. Have you heard her?
Oh, yes,
she does.
Yes.
She has, like, this vocal range where she can change her voice.
She was mocking every artist. It was great. It sounded just like them.
It did.
She's good.
Whitney Houston had a solid career and never could dance. I just want to point that out.
That is very true.
You know?
I want to dance with somebody. You should have practiced by yourself before you dance with somebody. I'm not even going to hold you. And God rest your soul. God rest your soul. But girl, you can't bring people into the equation if it looks crazy. So who are you guys giving it to? I'm going to give it to Ariana just because I love her.
I would have to abstain from voting on that.
It's tough.
I don't know.
It's tough.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it's going to be Beyonce or Adele. That's just it, because that's what it is. Yeah.
That's the sad truth of the matter, honestly. So let's go into R&B, one of my personal favorites. Best R&B Performance, Turning Me Up by BJ the Chicago Kid, who's awkwardly, I did not know before I decided to listen to him. I saw the nominations. I'm like, who is this? He's great.
That song was huge. That song was huge. Huge in the sense that on the adult R&B chart, it was there for weeks upon weeks upon weeks. And people liked it. Honestly, I never heard it once because it only played in certain places. Chicago loved it. Of course, you know, there's certain markets that absolutely love that song. And in New York, you probably never heard it once.
Never. When I heard it, I was like, my thing is, for nominations, I feel like we should all know about the song for it to get an award of that degree, you know? I'm like, what's going on here? I don't even know who these people are, but you're giving them a Grammy?
Right.
Maybe that's me not doing my homework, actually.
What was the song? I mean, it was successful in certain places, right? But right. What did it sound like? Was it, like, it reminiscent, was, almost nostalgic?
It was that. It was a lot of live instruments, which I loved. Yeah.
That's not something you hear now.
Yeah, a lot. It's very modern-day roots, I like to say.
Can you play?
I know.
Oh, yes.
I love a clip. Yeah.
Oh, let's, yes. Let me.
Who are the other nominees while you're finding that?
We have Permission Maya? By Ro James.
Oh, Ro James did good this year.
That was a great song.
When I talked to Ro James on the red carpet at the Essence Festival in July, the song had come out, and I'm like, it wasn't number one yet. He was just starting, very optimistic, very positive. And that song spent, I want to say, 2 months at number one on the urban, on the adult R&B chart.
That's great. That's an accomplishment, actually.
And this is his first, this is literally his first single. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, where do you go from there? Down.
Hopefully he keeps going up, because in this category, it's most likely he's going down. I hope he keeps going up.
Well, I mean, great. You know, once you
hear the clip. Baby, keep on turning me up. Yeah. Baby, keep on turning me up.
Brothers, it's R. Kelly, it's like smoothed out. Yeah.
Made me feel good. Mm-hmm. Made me want to slow dance and two-step a bit.
You know?
Chicago style.
It's definitely different.
Right?
Yeah. And it does feel like the old R&B. The way that it starts, it's slow. We don't hear that a lot now.
It's not
I appreciate it.
It's not a thing.
It's a fresh sound.
Yeah.
Nowadays.
So let's see where he goes with that. The next Music Soul Child was nominated for I Do, which I don't like that song. I think it's extremely off of Music's catalog. I don't like it at all.
It didn't do well on the chart, I'll say that.
Really?
I'm a Music Soul Child fan. Mm-hmm. On the Urban AC chart, that's my chart. That's what Cafe Mocha uses. It came, it went.
Uh-huh.
So it wasn't well received in radio.
The video itself, I'm not going to encourage you to watch the video because that's a waste of 3 to 4 minutes, but it's just very, it's not Music. I feel like Music puts heart into his videos. Like, right. Just Friends was a great video by him. This was, I don't know. He was like at a diner sitting. He was sitting outside of a diner. I was just like, Music, what are you doing? What are you doing? Did they force you to make this?
I was getting ready to say make it a record because the record company said make a record.
Yes, you owe us another record.
Like, it happens, you know, you have obligations and you can't get out of it. And you come out with, I don't know, might be a song like this.
But I mean, it got nominated for a Grammy. Someone liked it.
Yeah.
Someone liked it. So next up, we have Needed Me by Rihanna, which I actually think is offensive to have on this list. Because it doesn't give me that. I don't know. I feel like Rihanna is new age R&B, which is pretty much what's being pushed, actually.
Well, she's pop R&B. She's not R&B R&B. I don't think you put Rihanna next to Ledisi.
Oh, no.
You don't put Rihanna next to Music Soul Child or really the people in this group because she's more of a party pop. She's more of a pop princess than she is a R&B diva.
Yeah.
So I would agree. I mean, there were some pieces on Rihanna's album that I enjoyed. Mm. I had a good time with. Wouldn't necessarily. I like work. I like
the album was. I think the album
it
was fun.
Album.
It was fun. Great.
It doesn't. But to me, it doesn't qualify as R&B.
Yeah. That's my problem with it. I'm not taking anything away from Rihanna. I feel like the way that they're categorizing her is incorrect.
Yeah.
But she wants to win, and so you put her in a category next to Maya, and Music Soul Child, and people are going to vote for
what they know.
Right.
She's widely popular. Exactly. Right. Come on.
BJ, the Chicago kid. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
He's getting 10 votes.
Right. And all from of Chicago. Out of
Chicago.
Straight out of Chicago.
Right.
Play.
Right.
And then last but not least, who I think is going to get this personally, Cranes in the Sky by Solange. This was her first, not her first album, but this is the first album she had other than, what is it? What was the second album?
Just stop, okay? There's no... There,
it was so good!
Listen, there'll be no discussion
Hadley Street
with me
Dreams?
About Solange.
What?
I mean, that's like me and you making music in the basement.
Well, I heard it was received well. Her last album, it was...
And that's the truth. This
it was great.
I have the album at home, and I love it so much that I haven't pressed play on it one time.
What?
It's just sitting there.
A seat at the table. Really?
I see it on the charts.
It's there. It's there.
That Cranes in the Sky thing.
It's a beautiful that and know. Don't touch my hair. It's a very black conscious album, and I feel like we needed it. And what I love about this one, she did not have Beyonce feature. I think that was so smart on her part, because every time Beyonce's a part of a project, it is no longer about the person that's on the project. It's all about Beyonce. So I think that it was great that she did that. I think the album was amazing.
Okay.
And I think she may win because it was unexpected.
Okay.
And it also had a good message. I don't know, though.
She's always kind of lived under that shadow of Beyonce. Oh, you know, such a big figure for her to try to establish herself.
Right.
That's how I was received. It was kind of like, okay, this is who Solange is. And this is... And like, you're right. The timing was absolutely right. Because of the political climate that we're going through. And it was just what people... It resonated with people, especially because of the time.
Right.
Fine, I'll go home and listen
go
to
listen.
It.
Yeah, go listen it's to not it. Bad.
I think you'll like it. Yeah. I think you'll like it.
Okay.
Best Traditional R&B Performance. The Three of Me by William Bell. Woman's World by DJ the Chicago Kid. He's coming in strong. Sleeping with the One I Love, Fantasia. Angel by Layla Hathaway. And Can't Wait by Jill Scott. Me, personally, I'm giving this to Jill Scott. Can't Wait is amazing.
That record?
Jill Scott needs her props. I'm very tired of it.
I could listen to that all day on repeat.
I'm
very tired
of it. I like Jill Scott. I'm glad she's coming back.
Yes.
I'm so glad. I've listened to her in the past, and there are a lot of songs that I remember from her. But I'm glad she's coming back.
I think she's phenomenal. And the thing with Jill Scott is, you see how you're saying, I'm glad she's coming back? I don't think Jill ever really left.
But her songs weren't great.
Really?
I mean, to me, Jill is hit or miss.
Uh-huh.
And this Can't Wait was a hit.
Right.
You know, I have to play her regularly on the show. And I'm like, that's okay. It's okay. It's just all right.
What?
You know, but Can't Wait. I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm...
Oh, my God. Getting in the Way, A Long Walk. These are the songs of
those are the classics, though.
That's
those
true.
Are the good ones.
The recent ones,
You get into the newer ones on the album cuts, the ones that aren't released.
There's some that you skip over.
It's like, even the ones she did release, I'm like, that...
Yeah. Okay. I can't act like I don't know what you mean, but Can't Wait is definitely...
Hello, I'm representing North Carolina with Fantasia, I'm always going to say.
Fantasia can blow.
Yeah, Fantasia.
It's not even to be argued.
Her voice.
Not even to be argued. Fantasia is ridiculous.
Yeah, she deserves merit on her voice alone.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
and
she does.
And she's so passionate. Mm-hmm. I mean, she makes me want to live my dream.
Right.
Straight up. Seeing her being in the moment in what she loves and what she was put on this planet to do, it makes me want to kick off my shoes with her and go do whatever.
And you know she will kick her shoes off.
Exactly.
You know, because in the Shaka Khan tribute, she kicked them things off and started going to church. I was like, all right, Fantasia, baptize me. Layla Hathaway, I cannot. She is ridiculously talented.
Yeah. Haven't heard her.
Oh my, please. Please listen to Layla Hathaway.
It was nice to see her come back. That song, which of course is an old Anita Baker song from Anita Baker's first album. It was on number one on the chart for I don't know how long. I just stopped counting.
It's so good.
I was prepared to be offended by her redoing it because you don't ever want to redo something Anita Baker did.
Right.
And do it less than.
Yeah. Right. And I thought she did a... Yeah, exactly. She did a great job, but I haven't heard anything else on the album.
I don't know what's going on with Layla Hathaway. Her voice is that of Kiki Wyatt in the sense that they are so talented, but promotion, their team, bench them because they're horrible. The music never gets out. I don't understand that. How do you have some of the best vocals in the industry right now, and none of your music is out there. I don't understand.
Well, going to what you were saying about the same five people getting nominated, it's a campaign. Just like the Oscars, just like anything else, you have to have the team around you to push you. Yeah. Otherwise, you're not going to get out there.
You're not.
Because just like with the Oscars and other branches where voting is involved, the people who are voting, they know what's popular. They know what the buzz is about.
Right.
They're not necessarily immersed in whatever. I mean, I don't know what your format is.
Yeah.
I love movies. I've seen all the movies. You know, you're not going to catch me on a, oh, did you see? Yeah, I saw that. But the people who were, you know, voting aren't necessarily watching them. And they're not necessarily diehard fans like we are with Jill Scott, like we are with. So, you know, it's about campaigning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
And I feel like a lot of artists may have that attitude that their music should speak for itself. But in this world right now, where
that
everything
doesn't work.
Needs to... Yes, you have to push that, or it will never see the light of day.
And Layla Hathaway is really laid back.
Right.
She's
so
super chill.
If she keeps it up, she can lay in her room and keep humming. Because no one's going to hear her music.
But she hasn't, you know, she hasn't put out anything of this caliber, and I don't want to say caliber like what she put out last time was bad,
right.
But hasn't been received at all. I haven't seen a Layla Hathaway song on the R&B chart in I don't know how long. She runs out on the road with Joe Sample, who is a jazz musician.
Mm-hmm.
She makes money, and maybe that's good enough for her. Maybe she doesn't need the hit records. I don't know.
It could be a very India RE situation where it's like, I don't need fame. I'm just here for the love of singing. It could be that. I don't know. I would love to talk to her about it. But until then, you better start sending them songs out. Right. So let's talk about some of the nominees that you didn't expect to see. Me personally, Maya. I was very, very shocked about seeing Maya get a nomination.
Do you remember Maya?
I do.
Okay.
I just love her.
She was iconic in our era. Like, the 90s and the 2000s was Maya. It was like, Maya was a big part of that. And then after Mood Ring, that album, gone.
I haven't heard the new song.
I didn't know she had anything.
It's called Smooth Jones, and I didn't know it was a thing.
Can we hear it?
Yeah, let's hear it.
Let's do it.
Because that's going to be the only way you ever going to hear it, because it's not on the radio.
let's hear it.
Let's call a spade a spade. Please.
I like Maya.
I do, too.
I like her voice.
But what's going on here? The promotion, sis. Mm-hmm. You got
to
want more.
Going back to the promotion.
Wait. YouTube going to stop promoting things to me. That's what's going to stop happening. So disrespectful.
I'm just singing the Rugrats theme in my head now. They out trying to be on my team, but I don't want them. No. Said I'm out here just trying to succeed, but they don't want them. I only want you, baby, you know, you know. How you feeling, Angelique?
I'm feeling like I'm listening to Ciara's album, but
Me personally, Maya was never a threat vocally. Let's call it, she was a dancer.
Right.
But I was here for it. And I think that this is a good sound. I feel like it's still true to Maya. I'm not like, who is this?
It's Ciara. If you heard that blindly on the radio, who would that be?
It would be
Ciara. I'm team you. Okay, come on, that's a Ciara song and she rejects. She's like, you know, I don't want to put Russell in my records.
Right.
I'm team you. That's a daggone Ciara song that got passed off to Maya. You need some money real quick, Ma? Here, take the Ciara song.
A quick coin.
All the time. Yeah. You just, you know, even though you get brought a song, I think it can still come through. Like, you, whoever the artist is, it can still come through.
Right.
If it's Maya, but she's singing, you know, a song that was supposed to be for Ciara, I think she can still be Maya,
I think she can.
Yeah.
I just think promotion is piss poor. When was this released? It is her 8th independent project. Maybe that's why.
It's independent. When you don't have a record label behind you.
Right. You really gotta hustle.
It's just hard. You know, we've been talking about, like, these people coming back, right? You have to think about how it is from an artist's point of view, how they try to reinvent themselves with so many new noises. Sounds today, you know.
Some of it is noise.
Some of the popular sounds today. So I guess it can be a struggle, and it's hard. And you can end up with a hit or a miss.
I feel like it's hard in the sense that my sound was great back then, but my sound may not be great now, or it's not valued now. And it's like, this is my sound. So you want me to do what with
different
it?
Different times, right. Different sounds.
And that's hard. That is hard. Who would you guys like to see at the Grammys? Because I was shocked about... Who are y'all shocked is there? I know y'all are shocked about Maya. I saw y'all's faces. I saw it.
I just didn't know she had a song out. That's damn. Why I'm like, oh, she's at the Grammys?
Okay. Maya, sis, if you ever hear this, please promote and say no to some songs.
I don't have a problem with the song. I just think that it's not her song. I mean, I don't know what I would want to hear her come back with. Because that's the real question. What would... First of all, I'm thinking she's coming back with something a little more mature. Since she is a little more mature.
She looks great.
Does she? Turn the monitor around.
Oh, girl. We're about to have technical difficulties.
Oh, no, don't do it. Don't do it.
So now Maya looks good. She looks good.
Of course, she looks awesome.
Right?
Yeah.
Who would you guys like to see at the Grammys?
I don't know.
Prince?
Definitely. That would be great, but I mean, clearly that's not happening. I think I would like to see more Jaheims, Kiki Wyatts. I would love to see, I would definitely love to see a Ledisi. I would love to see Donnell Jones. I would love to see some revival acts from our time. I would love a Destiny's Child reunion that is the original Destiny's Child. If we want to bring Michelle in, that's cool too. No shade to Michelle. I think she was a great part of Destiny's Child. I just want to see, I want that nostalgic feeling. And that's what I'm missing from these award shows. I feel like I don't tune in because I don't think the performances are going to be of the same caliber that they were back then.
10 years ago.
You know,
right.
And I feel the same way you do. I'm like always craving that nostalgia and looking for things that remind me of the 90s. And
right.
There are more artists that are doing that, especially in hip-hop, that are catering to more of that sound. But then, are we in the minority, you know? Cause
we may be in the minority, honestly.
I find a lot of people in there, they're fine with the sound. You know, they get with the times, they welcome it. Some sounds are cool, some sounds are funky, but it's just, maybe it's just us that we're craving that.
Well, I think it depends on your level of passion about your music and what you like. I think it's part that, but... Every generation says the next generation's music is awful. So you guys are at that place. Right, you guys are at that place where you're right on the border of the old and the new.
It's very true.
That's true. And yeah. So, you know, for me, it's been garbage for years. I that Bruno Mars guy, I like him.
Yeah. He has an awesome voice.
He's so good, yeah. And he gives me soul. And that's the least I can ask at this point.
And he's got that throwback feeling.
He does.
Got
he does. That, yes.
That's
you know.
Why, that's probably why. I
it's
like
very
him.
That.
He's great. But yeah, I guess it's true. Are we just getting older?
It may be, right. But I mean, we're still a valuable part of society. And if you want albums to be sold. If you're going to keep putting these albums out, you're going to want them to be sold. At least cater to us. Just because we're not in the majority doesn't mean we don't count.
That's exactly what it means.
Yeah. And that's the problem.
No, see, that's exactly what it means. I mean, the issue to me with music in general and the way it's consumed traditionally is that radio plays something. Back when I started, it was every 2 hours, every 2.5 hours. The rotation now, you're going to hear Hello. Every hour and 20 minutes, you're going to hear it on the same station over and over and over again. And so what happens if you're a radio listener, even if you're a Pandora listener, because I stopped listening to radio and I listen, you know, for specific reasons.
Right.
I'll listen to Pandora thinking, ooh, I'll get more. No, I don't get more variety. I get still... Instead of being the same 20 songs you get on radio, it's the same 50 songs that you get on Pandora. So I think we're fed the same stuff over and over and over, and you get brainwashed. And after a while, that Taylor Swift song starts sounding good.
Because that's all you're going to hear.
Yeah.
That happens to me all the time with songs. I'm like, oh, this song's horrible. But then I heard it 15 times, and I'm like, you know what? It kind of grew on me.
Girl, you better get into it, because that's all you're going
to
hear.
I could leave it all. So, you know, I'll start to do that. I'll leave the songs on, and And like, it's true. Next thing you bought the album.
Right.
No, and so I think because this is what they're fed. And now, you know, versus when I started in radio, there were clearly defined stations.
Right.
This was the rock station. The rock station only played rock. Now you turn to Kiss. Kiss sounds just like Power. Power sounds K-Rock just like, sounds you know like what I'm saying?
I mean,
So the lines are gray and people are really consuming a lot more of the same songs than ever before.
Right.
So that's why they're okay with it, because they're hearing it over and over and over again and, you know, you get brainwashed.
And that brings me to my next point. I was reading an article titled 8 Reasons Why R&B Has Died in the Black Community, and they brought up some great points as to why R&B may not be thriving to the best of its ability. And one of them that actually caught my attention was that there's too much focus on physical attributes and not enough on talent. So they had a big picture of Ciara, shade. I was like, you know what? I'm here for this. And then Tinashe, I just put down because I like Tinashe. However, I'm still trying to figure out what we're doing here. Like, all hands have been on deck for a while now, but I'm still not liking the music. It's just, I don't know what her purpose is. She's very Cassie to me. I'm like, can we get people that can blow? Can we get people that can sing? I don't care if you can't dance. Adele can't dance. She just stand on stage in her big dress and sweep side to side.
That's good.
And give occasional tear. Nothing more.
Well, I think as long as, and for as long as we're a visual medium, and music is, mm-hmm. ever since the 80s when music videos came out,
mm-hmm.
they're going to want pretty people. You know, period. They're going to want the pretty, sexy, hot, sellable thing.
It's true. It's just the way the industry is.
Yeah.
It sells.
Okay, so do you think that
that's... It shouldn't be that way, though.
Right.
It should not, yes.
Right, definitely.
To that point.
But do you think that that is one of the reasons why R&B may be suffering the way it is?
No. No, I think that's why music in general is suffering, but I don't think R&B necessarily... Because, you know, Jill Scott been big as a house since the day she came out. And everybody goes, oh, she's so pretty. You don't know how many guys I've met that, you know, I don't do big girls, but I'll do Jill Scott. You know, because
Angie Stone.
Yeah.
Angie Stone, come through, sis.
Yeah.
Oh, I love Angie Stone.
I do, too.
Oh, my God. Iconic. okay. The next point they brought up. Too much sex. The music is, you know how back in the day it was more suggestive and it was
sensual,
subliminal,
yeah.
And we eventually had to listen back and be like, wait, what you talking about? As opposed to now where it's like, I'm going to throw you against the wall, bang your head 2 times, we're going to get it done.
It's less subtle now.
I don't know, it's very much LA men. It's like LA men, they just come up to you and just...
you said that are LA men, so what is that?
It's just very... It's just very, I want to say... direct in a sense, where it's kind of just like, you don't have to work for it. I'm just gonna yes right. or no, and I'm just like, no, give my mind something to work with. Give me some type of pleasure for the mind, I feel like, you know. And that's the problem with music. I feel like artists like Trey Songz, artists like Chris Brown, who honestly I don't think are that great vocally anyway,
Chris can dance.
That is very attractive, but that's not singing. So at the end of the day, it's kind of like, be a little smoother in your approach to addressing sex or whatever you're trying to promote in your music. Oh, Genuine. That's why Genuine got so many kids. Genuine got about 10 kids. That's a whole football team. Genuine started the Jets. Y'all ain't know?
I would agree that the blatantness of the sexuality is a turnoff. I mean, I like listening to the old stuff and the new stuff, but a lot of the new stuff is too... nasty, where I'm sitting there, you know, I want to play the new Usher song on Cafe Mocha, but I'm thinking this is semi-offensive to me. So the people who are 10 and 15 years older than me, even though it's Usher, they're going to be like, wait, did he say I want to get between your you know, and there is no mystique, no mystery, and it's just flat out nasty.
Right. And it makes it awkward because you know how you're younger, so you hear certain songs with your parents and it's kind of like, all right, this is cool. It's not so outright. Now, I can't listen to these songs with my mom. And then, God forbid I know the words, she's going to look at me crazy. I can't be a part of it.